Do you believe that a technology exists wherein speech can be encoded and transmitted via microwaves so that it can be heard inside the human skull without the use of a receiver?
She's convinced the people who harassed her were under mind control and didn't even know it.
Somebody has to make them do things, you know, against, without their knowing it.
But why choose Cheryl?
You're going to need to experiment on a lot of people. You can't do it ethically, so you're going to do it covertly, you know.
She thinks she knows what put her on the government's radar.
Before I went to UC Davis, I went to the Army recruiting office. I filled out the forms. I put in my application, but I went to UC Davis instead. And then after that was when this happened. After networking with other victims, they have that connection. Former people who applied to the CIA, former people who have relatives in the government or the CIA are often targets.
Are the minds of innocent citizens being controlled by government-sanctioned experiments?
But which is now marginally feasible. This potential is the technical capability to influence directly the major portion of the approximately 6 billion brains of the human species, by generating neural information within a physical medium within which all members of the species are immersed, unquote.
The military acronym for voice-to-skull technology, which relies on a scientifically documented phenomenon known as the microwave auditory effect.
The observation of the phenomenon came way back during the Second World War, and the radar operators, you know, accidentally noticed that when they stand in front of the radar, sometimes they can hear clicks in their head. Somebody by the name of Alan Fry had talked to some of the radar operators based on their report, and he conducted a very simple laboratory experiment, indeed showed that human beings can hear the radar pulses. They were not just making it up.
They wanted to know what the significance of something like this would be if man had another sensory motor input. And of course, the possibilities are staggering. Like, you have another sense, like sight, only you're not using it. What do you think that would imply? It means you're walking around being blind to something that's constantly giving you inputs, but you're not aware of it. Well, the first implication on that would be a weapon.
There was some concerns because the American embassy in Moscow was reported to have been bombarded by microwaves. So the speculation was that, are they trying to gather intelligence, or are they trying to actually mess with the brains of the embassy personnel?
And it used to just to be about triggering emotions. You could change people's brain chemistry pretty readily, change their emotional state pretty easily. But when you get down to the idea of thoughts and being able to manipulate those, that requires much a different kind of sophistication.
Can we hear sounds without using our ears? Not only is it possible, says Begich, he can prove it using sound recorders, Brad Daw.
Don't even need these. They're tapping directly into our minds, controlling us with powerful invisible microwaves that can alter the very way we think and act, making us believe anything they want us to.